most Indians go through a mental health crisis at one point or the other.
Nobody loves you, nobody likes you. That is the feeling of depression, that dark feeling inside you that tells you that, no, I am unloved, I am unliked.
I used to believe that I was happy. I really felt that I was happy.
I felt I couldn't openly communicate for fear of losing out on more friends.
I had like started having very serious thoughts of self-harm and stuff like that.
There is a beautiful world out there. Fall in love with everything, fall in love with life, and fall in love with yourself.
I moved to Chennai right after college. So I studied in Karaikal. It was kind of a small town, but things moved very fast. I think I could call myself a high functioning individual. I've never had like a chance to stop. So I've always been working towards something or the other. Only recently did I realize that I was going through a lot of anxiety. I used to have anxiety attacks and I didn't even know what it was. And it's one thing to ask for help, but it's another thing to even recognize that you need help when you don't even know that you are going through something in the first place.
I was diagnosed with depression and anxiety when I was around 13. I started to think that, you know, people didn't like me. I started hating on myself for not being this way. I started creating a stereotype for myself, this particular perfect girl image for myself. And when I didn't meet that criteria that I had set for myself, I took it very hard upon myself, and that was a particularly stressful time for me.
I wouldn't say anxiety attacks, but then I felt like claustrophobic, I guess, because I was staying in the same room for quite a long time. I was not allowed to go outside because of the lockdown. It felt like the walls were coming close to me, and I started breathing heavily.
For me, I need people around me. If I'm alone, like I'm put into more thoughts, I kind of feel like I'm not able to concentrate properly, and I feel the urge to, you know, stop the work or you know, procrastinate.
I was overly conscious about what I said to my friends because I feared judgment, and it was becoming an issue where I felt I couldn't openly communicate for fear of losing out on more friends.
Nobody loves you, nobody likes you. That is the feeling of depression, that dark feeling inside you that tells you that, no, I am unloved, I am unliked, nobody cares about me. That monster in your head, that's what depression is.
I went through clinical depression that was undiagnosed, and I realized that it was taking a turn for the worse when I had like started having very serious thoughts of self-harm and stuff like that. Lone Pack is something that we started when I was in college, in my last year of college. And the reason why I felt strongly about it, and both my other co-founders too, who are my friends, felt strongly about it, was we had lived experiences with mental health. And that made us realize about how difficult it is for a person who is facing some issue with mental health to seek help in India. I think as an organization, Lone Pack has been very strongly believe in the idea that internet and technology can enable people to create change, enable, you know, like people to seek out better mental health alternatives. Our most important initiative, Lone Pack Buddy, which tries to provide anonymous, free peer-to-peer support, it is run online through the website and our Android app.
So we wanted to host so-called listeners who would provide that emotional support, be that space for them to reach out to when, you know, they didn't have anyone that they could turn to.
A lot of us go through everyday emotions, and it doesn't have to be very aggressive. It doesn't have to be too large for you to take notice. It could even be everyday stress or everyday burnout, and it's just the fact that you're too tired to process something. Just being there to listen to is, I realized, it's a valuable asset for yourself and for the friends around you.
So normally when you start out something, you expect your friends and family to come in and support you and get that reach, right? But I feel even there we face a lot of challenges, and I think a lot of people weren't even willing to like touch the subject 5 years back, I would think. Like now it's gotten a bit better, but a lot of people we reached out to for sponsorships, etc., weren't very particularly you know, like enthusiastic about supporting mental health as a cause.
I mean, funding is obviously a huge issue when it comes to nonprofit. So not being able to promise funding, but at the same time looking for pro bono ways of support.
Without the internet, I don't think any of what LoanPack has done would have been possible. And not just in terms of the campaigns we do or our credibility, but even in terms of working, right? So since we are completely volunteer run and our volunteers are based across, you know, like different cities and different countries, right? It's only been through the internet that we collaborate and work together. I would think of LoanPack as an internet first mental health nonprofit. All our online initiatives have played a huge, huge role in the impact that we have been able to have.
Having that domain.org is always the first thing that, let's say, a lot of people, when they're going to search for nonprofits or any organization, that .org gives a certain faith that, okay, this is a reliable source, it's a trustable source I can turn to.
When you talk to someone who has been through something similar that you have, it's not just the empathy, but the knowledge that they know what you're talking about.
You need to have the determination to think that, okay, I do not want to be in this place again. You need to recognize that you are in a bad place and you need to want to get out of it, because nobody can help you if you don't want to help yourself.
It didn't bridge the gap completely, but then it did bridge to a certain extent. Like, I was able to talk to them, I was able to connect with them. They were also able to connect with me.
A lot of people are happy to just be of help in any way. And the LoanPack Buddy people definitely are. So I think you just have to take that one small step.
There is a beautiful world out there. Fall in love with everything, fall in love with life, and fall in love with yourself.